This video is from Lodi Design Lab, School of Design, Art, Architecture, Planning, Consulting and Research.
This is topic number one, and you can see this is the scene. These are two standard lights and this is one photometric light. Now we'll go to light list. See, these two are omni lights, one photometric light. Now if we look at V-Ray light list, so I keep V-Ray light switched off. Now this is V-Ray dome light. Basic parameters are all done. It has got V-Ray SDRI also, and the process of having the SDRI linked to material is done the way it is done in other tutorial. Now in camera view, if I render it, so this is giving the rendering without having V-Ray dome light. Means this particular scene is with default standard at photometric light without SDRI. So it has some darkness. Wherever lights are not falling directly, we will save it in JPEG. Now we'll check that whether background is set or not. It is already there. This is the background which has been used. Now we'll go to V-Ray light list. We'll switch it on. Now it is going to work. Render. Now SDRI file is going to work in this interior space. The area which is getting indirect light is going to be highlighted more, which was not there in direct light. JPEG. So the scene is with default light and SDRI file together.
Topic number two, V-Ray dome with global illumination. This is dome light with basic settings and V-Ray SDRI, which we generally take to material slot. Then after, we will go to render setup, and in indirect illumination we will switch it on so that GI starts working. After switching on indirect illumination, we will have to set primary bounces as irradiance map, and irradiance map, after that secondary bounce, light cache. In irradiance map we'll have current preset set to very low. This is a testing phase, so we'll have it very low. We'll have show calc phase so that calculation while rendering can be seen. Light cache, we will go to subdivision. Though it requires a higher subdivision, but we'll keep it less for test rendering. And rest of the things are okay. Show calculation phase so that we could see in rendering time. Now we will render it, and this is what is the calculation phase actually. So the calculation for phase for the light cache and irradiance both are going to be visible before the final output. So bounce of light is quite visible here. So the whole process is as such that the direct light which hits the surface, from that direct surface it goes to adjoining surfaces after getting reflected back. That's why it also bounces the color of the surface from one surface to another, and reflection of the light happens so accurately, the whole scene gets complete light. Even the area which was receiving indirect light, not getting any direct light, also starts showing up. So this is the beauty of having GI. So global elimination is all about infusing the scene with indirect light or reflected light. So this is the beautiful rendering of VA Dome SDRI with GI, global illumination. Now we will save it.
Topic number 3, VA Dome without global illumination. Now we will look at this VA Dome with all basic parameters, then VA SDRI and full dome. We go to material again and we drag drop VA SDRI into material the way we did earlier also. Now we'll go to render setup. In render setup we will try to look at indirect illumination, which is on. We'll switch it off,
and then after we will have basic setting of frame buffer, global switches, image sampler, and then after VRay environment we'll keep it off, and VRay color mapping exponential.
We will remove the VRay log. So in this particular view,
if GI is not there, then what happens? Actually it is getting darker. You can see the ceiling, which was receiving golden brown color, is actually getting removed, because now the indirect light has been switched off. So there's no indirect light. There's direct light from the standard light and photometric light, and VA dome light is also working, but there's no support of GI. So global illumination is switched off. So this is the result. Now we'll save it.
The portion which is not getting hit with direct light has gone darker because GI is switched off. So GI is all about having light distributed even in the darker area. Topic number 4, VRay Dome store with irradiance. So this is the basic scene. Now we'll go to dome with all basic settings, dome multiplier, and then we'll look at VRay SDRI and spherical full dome. This is stored with irradiance, so we'll be learning this. In the render setup, we'll go to indirect illumination, we'll switch it on. Irradiance map and light cache, we did it earlier also. After doing all these things, we'll switch on store with irradiance map and render. So this render which is there can be seen that there's more line into the space. So this option is similar to setting environment. Topic number 5, VRay Dome with environment. So this is the very same setup. Now we'll go to VRay Dome with all basic setting, which we have been seeing in other topics also. Same VRay SDRI full dome.
Now this store with irradiance will switch off. Instead we'll go to the VRay setting, render setup.
In the VRay environment section,
now we'll go to VRay environment, we'll switch it on with the default multiplier 1. This will have same effect the way we have seen store with the irradiance. We will also copy the environment map from the environment and effects to this VRay environment, and now we'll render it. So it is going to produce the same effect which we have seen in the last topic. So you can use either this way or that way.
So there's plenty of light in this space. Topic number 6, V-Ray Dome with Sky Portal. Same scene setting again. Here we have used V-Ray light. This is V-Ray Dome light with the same very basic settings which we did earlier also. Yeah, same drag drop to the material. And then after, we use another V-Ray light. This V-Ray light is not dome this time. This is V-Ray plane light, V-Ray plane. We cover the whole opening from outside. And we size according to the opening, the length and width. Now we'll switch on Sky Portal. Actually, Sky Portal is used to take outdoor light, outside light inside. Actually, it fuses outside light effectively into a space. Now we'll render it. So this also works very effectively in taking all type of exterior light to interior. So Sky Portal is actually taking outside light portal to interior space. So this also gives very nice effect. And this is the fine rendering. It may cause over lighting, but then one can reduce by reducing the intensity of dome light or SDRI lighting. Now we'll save this file into JPEG. Topic number 7, V-Ray Dome with Simple. Again, the same scene, same SDRI file with all same settings, but reduced intensity multiplier. Same spherical full dome and V-Ray SDRI. We'll switch on indirect illumination. Now what we'll do, we'll take this V-Ray plane from outside, the very same size, with all plane and basic settings which we see here. This Sky Portal which is lying outside, instead we will use Simple. So we bring a V-Ray plane light inside when we need to save time, and to save time we can use Simple instead of Sky Portal. So this is the rendering with Simple, where V-Ray plane light which was lying outside is actually brought inside in Simple. It is kept outside when it is being rendered in Sky Portal. So this is the final brilliant effect of Simple. Maximum amount of time is taken by V-Ray Dome with SDRI. Least is taken by V-Ray plane Simple, and Sky Portal V-Ray plane lies somewhere in between.
Thank you very much.